In a way, a capacitor is a little like a battery, although they work in completely different ways. Capacitors and batteries both store electrical energy. If you have read how batteries work, then you know that a battery has two terminals. Inside the battery, chemical reactions produce electrons on one terminal and absorb electrons on the other terminal. A capacitor is much similar than a battery, as it can't produce new electrons, it only stores them. In this video, we will learn exactly what a capacitor is and how to work it. Inside the capacitor, the terminals connect to two metal plates separated by a non-conducting substance or dielectric. You can easily make a capacitor from two pieces of aluminium foil and a piece of paper. It won't be a particularly good capacitor in terms of its storage capacity, but it will work. In theory, the dielectric can be any non-conductive substance. However, for practical applications, specific materials are used that the best suit the capacitor's function. Mica, ceramic, cellulose, propylene, mylar, teflon, and even air are some of the non-conductive materials used. The dielectric dictates what kind of capacitor it is and for what it is best suited. Depending on the size and type of dielectric, some capacitors are better for high frequency uses, while some are better for high voltage applications. Capacitors can be manufactured to serve any purpose, from the smallest plastic capacitor in your calculator to an ultra capacitor that can power a commuter bus. NASA uses glass capacitors to help wake up the space shuttle's circuitry and help deploy space probes. Here are some of the various types of capacitors and how they are used. Air, often used in radio tuning circuits. Mylar, most commonly used for timer circuits like clocks, alarms, and counters. Glass, good for high voltage applications. Ceramic, used for high frequency purposes like antennas, X-ray, and MRI machines. Supercapacitor, powers electric and hybrid cars. Let's go, we will take a closer look at exactly how capacitors work. Electric power is the flow of electric charge, which is what electrical components harness to light up or spin or do whatever they do. When current flows into a capacitor, the charges get stuck on the plates because they can't get past the insulating dielectric. Electrons, negatively charged particles, are stuck into one of the plates and it becomes overall negatively charged. The large mass of negative charges on one plate pushes away like charges on the other plate, making it positively charged. The positive and negative charges on each of these plates attract each other because that's what opposite charges do. But with the dielectric sitting between them, as much as they want to come together, the charges will forever be stuck on the plate until they have somewhere else to go. The stationary charges on these plates create an electric field, which influences electric potential energy and voltage. When charges group together on a capacitor like this, the cap is storing electric energy just as a battery might store chemical energy. Dear sir, thanks for watching my videos. For more updates, please subscribe to our channel Learning Engineering and get a notification to press the bell icon.